Hi Summoners, my name is Vulcan and with me is Gisto, your host for today's Rift Talk. New season started, Gisto, new year, but have you had a resolution for your rank?
Yeah, syempre naman. Natapos ko na placement matches ko, so very excited to see saan ako matatapos this season.
Kumusta naman placement mo?
I went 6-4 and I got placement platinum. How about you?
So many, I think for right now, we have a new season and I think we also have a new video that Riot themselves released to welcome the new season. Mm-hmm. So let's have a look at it, Gisto.
Yeah, play the video.
Let's check it out. I like how they use Yasuo for the first time. I think it's the first time.
Yeah, I think it's the first time Yasuo is in the cinematic.
Ah, yung sa story ni Yasuo, di ba? He killed someone off.
And everyone wants to kill his brother in the Lord. Well, he killed.
I think this is the first time Thalia was 3D animated. It's like, I think this is Xerath. This is Xerath.
Yeah,
I think this is the Lord. Tapos si Yasuo yung mga mag-try sa I like how they're using the in-game sometimes, in the sense that it's like a game itself. Is that Illaoi? Ah, it's Illaoi.
I like how they show it.
Climb.
Napakaganda ng cinematic na yun. Tuwa ako sa job na ginawa ng Riot. Like all the work that went in. Ikaw, Vulcan, anong maisip mo tungkol sa video?
Yung Yasuo, right? Kasi I feel like when I saw the Yasuo, it's gonna give the mentality that Yasuo looks really cool in that cinematic. Medyo maangas. So, malay mo, dumami yung mga Yasuo sa 2018.
And actually, especially server natin, sobrang daming gumagamit itong Yasuo. And siyempre, tinanong namin yung community, toxic nga ba mga Yasuo main?
Toxic? I don't think that's the right word. I feel like misunderstood that data.
Misunderstood. I mean, you did ask and some of you answered, so I think we'll go over the comments.
So tingin natin kung talagang toxic yung mga Yasuo players.
Sige.
Thing is, I'm lucky it's English. Thing is, we have popularized that Wakban Yas so much that even decent grown-ups who are just having a bad day wants to play Yas and roleplay the whatever toxicity the net had envisioned Yas mains have. That is no longer funny, because you know, everyone assumes that if you pick Yas, you are toxic, and we all know Yas isn't as his strongest in his laning phase, but he's going in depth now. Yeah. So yeah, maybe the person isn't having his best day, so let's just leave him be, as long as he doesn't intentionally throw the game. I know two Yasuo mains that aren't toxic, and they actually are the only Yasuo mains in my friends list so far. Respeto ba din sa lahat kahit mak ng trip lang. Laruin ko, laro ko. Maya, may Tagalog so bad. Pareho lang tayo ng goal na mananalo. Respeto. Smiley face. GL, have fun po sa lahat ng mga sir. Shoutouts kila Adam Joshua at Miguel. Adam Joshua and Miguel for not being toxic. So I think we have our two Yasuo mains. So I think we have like, they're the future Yasuo mains in this country. I think you can change the toxicity mentality in this country. Edit. Forgot about Kyle and Jerick pala. May limang shoutout. So again, shout out to Adam Joshua, Miguel, Kyle, Jarek, and Aaron. So, I have high hopes for the futures of Yasuo with these two mains. Why don't you go pick Justin?
Diyos ko, may nakatabing nga ako sa shop eh, Yasuo main. Nasa around 10 to 12 years old lang siya. Medyo bata. Keyboard warrior si Kuya. Umuuga na yung table sa sobrang gigil niya sa pag-type. Okay, so, sa unang comment nakita natin, medyo open-minded siya. Meron siyang mga kaibigan na hindi toxic. Pero, judging from your experience ito, keyboard warrior daw yung Yasuo main. 10 to 12 years old lang.
I think it's safe to say that I did see a kid playing LOL in a cafe. Tapos, ang toxic. Tapos... So I think, yeah, I really relate to that comment. Wala sa chop yan, nasa tao.
Tama, tama.
To be fair, I do play Yasuo. I used to main him, pero I don't know why that I started to become so toxic. So I think it's in the champion, not in the person. Wait, I am a very toxic person.
Well, I think I agree with that. Nasa tao nga yan, wala sa champion. Kasi hindi lang naman sa Yasuo, kahit sa ibang champion may nakikita tayo, toxic pa rin sila. Kahit hindi naman sila Yasuo main.
But I think it's in the champion kasi medyo tilt yung champion ng Yasuo eh. He's weak in laning. For me, I think we have... I kind of want more of these.
99.9% pagka-kampi 99% okay, I think gets ko to. 99.9% pagka-kampi toxic yung Yasuo. Pero 99% pagkalaban hindi sila toxic.
Lumagaling sila?
Yeah, pagkalaban. So, malas nito. Yung magaling ni Yasuo nakakalaban yun. Feeling ko salty siya.
To be fair, sometimes when I say Yasuo top, I kinda underestimate the Yasuo. And I end up being toxic and I'm the one feeding.
And I think marami tao nahihirapan laruin si Yasuo, kaya ganun eh.
So feel ko nga, I think that settles it. Yasuo is not that toxic, it's the person.
Yeah.
I think. But it's still double wager.
Mm-hmm.
I think we have something very special for our viewers out there. The first episode of Rift Talk will actually show you the PGS intro video. We haven't seen it just yet, me and Gisto. But I think you guys seen the trailer. Have you seen the trailer?
I've seen the teaser.
The teaser, yeah. Pala.
It was shared on the Pro Gaming Series Facebook page.
That
I saw the teaser and now I'm super excited for the whole thing.
So, let's watch together, all of us, because this is also my first time watching it, so.
Let's watch. There's a moment in your bones when the fire takes over. Blood is running, heart is pumping as the battle gets closer. They can say what they want now, 'cause we'll be screaming out, we can be heroes everywhere. Really gives you a sense of
singing Malaga, so.
Yeah.
But I wonder if the community is excited because, as far as I can tell, I mean, if you really follow the PGS page, naman, I feel like Mineski has two imports na. No? I think may sobrang daming usapan sa mga imports, Gisto. Sa tingin mo, anong mga imports sa Mineski?
They have imports in the AD carry again. Because last week we
saw Celestion.
Yeah, we saw Celestion, unfortunately, he's gone. And now we get to see two imports from Mineski in the jungle and AD carry. So I'm very excited. Because if you import, usually sa team, it's hard because there's a language barrier. It's hard to communicate.
Yan ang isang problema ni Celestion dati. I mean, I've been here for too long, so I sometimes can't speak Tagalog, but not that well.
And of course, it's hard for the team, yun, so maybe nakapag-adjust ni Mineski, makita natin pag nag-start na yung split.
But for me, one thing that popped out in my eyes is that I think it was the return of Naga. Kasi
medyo matagal na nawala yung Naga esports eh. So it's coming back to split. So especially Rebenga is now playing in Naga, which is from TME. Mm-hmm.
And you mentioned TME. I really like that they stuck with their core roster, and I really feel like Mineski and TME, they look like sila yung pinaka-solid na teams ngayon, and feeling ko may rivalry na nagsisimula sa kanila.
Yung man, that's what I'm feeling. I think the new rivalry right now is, remember, TME, even though Mineski had the import Celestia who did really well, they still won. Now, I think Mineski to bring in two imports, so maybe TME and Mineski will have that rivalry again.
Yeah, and malim, ma-reverse sweep naman ngayon ng Mineski ang TME pag umabot tayo dun.
Who knows? We can't say that, you can't. Yeah.
Not yet, not yet.
Caster curse.
It's still yeah. Early to say. Pero
for me, I think the newer teams, yung Barcy X Rage Esports, I think there are many rookies in the speeches right now. Especially sila si Iconic, yung sa streamer sa isang Twitch, tapos LCL Champion, right? If I recall.
Yeah, and speaking of LCL Champions, binanggit mo din Barcy X Rage Esports, yung mid laner nila si Jaime, he went by Janine back in the LCL. LCL Champion din siya, and nag-transition na siya into the PGS. And I'm very interested to see paano siya mag-a-adjust kasi LCL is very different from the pro gaming series.
This is really what I like about the PGS. Yung mga bata, I can't really say bata in a sense that it's students entering the
younger people
entering the PGS. It's like a new blood, new fresh, new mix,
new talent.
And you can see that maybe may talaga iba sa LCL. May you move up a level. You can see that there's a career here.
Yeah, and pinag-uusapan natin yung rookies ngayon, di ba? Mm. Gusto ko i-highlight si Demon galing sa TNC. Hindi yung TNC Demon galing sa Dota 2 team nila, bagong Demon to. Siya yung AD carry ngayon ng TNC, and one of the things that really stands out sa kanya is if you constantly look at the challenger ladder, both in solo queue and flex queue, palagi siyang nandun sa... Hindi siya bumabagsak ng top 5 ng challenger. Ganun siya ka-solid as a player, and now mag-professional debut na siya sa PGS Spring Split.
So I think we have a lot of new talents, new rookies coming in. Especially, man, when you said Demon is always top 2 challenger or always top, never falls behind 5, I think that's pretty impressive. So, hype talaga nitong PGS na to, no? January 19.
Yeah, and of course, di ba sa PGS, naita natin, parang may clear cut na top 4, Mineski, TME, IPT, AEX. I think this is a split na, even though palagi natin sinasabi to, feeling ko this is the split na may magbabago talaga dun sa top 4 na kinoconsider ni teams. Kasi everyone is stacked.
Everyone's coming back. Mm-hmm. This is all or nothing, yung bagong PGS. We talked a lot about the players, the teams itself. And it's very... You know what we haven't talked about? The exciting things for our viewers, especially this January 19, start ng PGS. 3 p.m., you know our outlets. If you don't know, it's going to be... We're always live on our Facebook page. If you haven't liked our Facebook page, Pro Gaming Series, PH, search it up. It's right there. Plus, we have a treat, a really good treat for our viewers out there. Mm-hmm. Watch out for our website, esports.garena.ph/stream, for you to actually catch the stream itself. But also, we have a lot of stuff. We talked about the teams, not in detail, but if you're very curious, check out our website for the roster itself.
So Vulcan, binanggit mo may promos.
Ayun.
Para sa viewers. Baka gusto mo sabihin tukol saan yan.
I can't say too much, medyo secret, pero I think I can give a hint naman. Like, let's just say that we'll have a more generous giveaway in a sense that everyone has a chance to win something. Each stream, each match, you can guarantee that you'll be glued to the stream.
Yeah, so may aabangan yung viewers every time manunod silang PGS, so.
That's what I like about it. May suspense na. There's that uncertainty that you may like. So I think this is for PGS. Again, January 19th. See you there. So I think that settles for today's Rift Talk episode. We talked about the asshole being the toxic of the community.
We talked about the PGS.
Talked about the PGS. January 19th, by the way, and the exciting things that's in store for you guys. So stay tuned. So we'll be signing off. Once again, I'm Vulcan. With me was Gisto. See you for next week's Rift Talk here. But don't forget that we want to hear you guys out. If you have any suggestions, Gisto, I think... What can you say to the viewers?
Yeah, kung may gusto kayong makita namin pag-usapan or kung meron kayong gusto ipagawa sa amin, comment down below.
Whatever you say, we might do. We'll think about it. So we'll hear you guys out more. But till then, like, share, comment, and subscribe in our YouTube channel, PH Garena. Or Garena PH, you can just search it up there. And see you next week for Rift Off.